Hi guys, so in previous video we have learned how to multiply decimals. So there were three categories, so we have dealt with all those three categories. Okay, so based on that, I think you all have done question number 1, 2, 4 and 5 is also of the same kind. So I'll be doing question number 6, Roman number 1 question for you. I'll be discussing few questions so that we will be done with the exercise 3C. Okay, so let us see question number 6, Roman number 1. You all can refer exercise 3C. So question number 6, Roman number 1. So we have multiplication of 1.1, 0.1, 0.01. So this is a type 3 category sum where we have multiplication of decimal with a decimal, again with a decimal. So we have already learned how to do this multiplication. Okay, so we will be considering all these decimal numbers as a concrete whole number. Okay, so let us first multiply this two. So 11 into 1, we are just considering the whole numbers. Okay, we are neglecting the decimals for a time being. So 11 ones are 11. So according to what we learned earlier, what do? We place a decimal after 1, 2 digits. Okay, so our answer will be multiplication of this two will be 0.11, again multiplied with 0.01. So again, for this multiplication also we will be considering this numbers as a whole number. Okay, so when we multiply 11 into 1, that is again 11. So here the decimal is placed after 2 digits and here the decimal is placed after 2 digits. So in the result, we will be placing the decimal after 4 digits. Okay, so we have 2 digits here, so 1, 2. So if we don't have any digit, then we can always put a 0 to make 4 digits. Okay, so this will be our answer. So this is the answer for question number 6, 1. Okay, so now all other questions are of same kind, which you can try. So let us solve question number 7. Okay, so question number 7, Roman number 1, we have 1.4 square. So 1.4 square means we are multiplying this 1.4 two times. Okay, this 2 implies that we are multiplying the number 2 times. So this will again reduce to multiplication of decimal with a decimal. So we will consider this two decimal numbers as a whole number. So when we multiply 14 and 14, so it will be 4 fours are 16. So we have decimal after one digit here, we have decimal after one digit here. So in the result we will place our decimal after 2 digits, counting from the rightmost end. So this will be 1, 2. So our answer will be 1.96. Okay. So question number 7, all other questions are of this kind. Roman number 5, we have 0.4 cube. So this cube means we are multiplying this number 3 times. So it will be 0.4 into 0.4 into 0.4. This is also multiplication of a decimal number. I hope you all can multiply this. Okay, please try this. Now we have a word problem here, question number 8, 9 and 10. I will be doing question number 8 for you all. 9 and 10, it's a similar type of question. You all try on your own. Okay. So question number 8 says the cost of a book is ₹84.50. find the cost of 13 such books. Okay, so cost of a book, that is one book costs ₹84.50. we need to find cost of 13 such books. So it is nothing but a sum on multiplication of numbers. Okay. So if one book costs rupees 84.50, then cost of 13 books will be equals to 13 into cost of one book, that is 84.50. So this will be your answer. Okay, so again, this is the multiplication of a whole number by a decimal. Okay, so we have, for this type of multiplication, what do? We consider this decimal number as a whole number. So we will do this multiplication. 3 0 0, 5 is 15, carried 1, 4 3 is 12, 13, 8 3 is 24, 25, 1 0 is 0, 5 4 8. So we get 109850. So here in multiplier we have a decimal after two digits. Okay, so in our answer also we will be placing a decimal after two digits. So our answer will be rupees 1098.50. So this is the cost of 13 books. Okay, so same way you can attempt question number 9, 10. Always remember, you need to do step wise. Okay, you need to show each and every step and get to the answer. Okay, so try question number 9 and 10. I think you all can solve this question. Okay, with this we will be done with multiplication of decimals. In next video I'll come up with division of decimals video. Okay, till then, see you, bye.